Live Demon Studios with Lux Ray Pokemon! You're gonna have to use an Ultra Ball on this one. Team Rocket is the only team. That is awesome. Next up, we have Sarah and Randy Lynn as Papyrus and Sans from Undertale! Next up, we have some OC. The Willis Kids as Zokira and Lee. Category. Coming up next, we've got Andrew Lane as Kirito from Sword Art Online! Showing that other sword, letting everybody know he can dual wield. Nozomi Tojo from Live! Like I needed to tell you that. Coming up next, we've got Kaylee Westbrook as God Tier from Homestuck! Where's my trolls? Stage next, we have Arthur as Revolutionary War England from Hattalia! Hope everyone's ready to start mashing some buttons because we've got Alejandro and Abby as Bryn and Felicia. Ryu! It's Ryu, of course it is! Yeah. Ryu and Felicia from Capcom! Be able to catch him in this generation of the game, but there's Milo Flygon Pokemon!
Gotta catch him all.
This
And it's awfully nice to have the actual person here, because we have Undyne as Undyne from Undertale! Is it unfair to cosplay yourself? I'm not sure. Coming up next, we have the nobles, Sans and Papyrus from Undertale. That's right. That is the correct reaction. I might be saying the name, and I might be just telling you that you're Jafriki. We've got Jafriki as Roman Torchwick from Ruby. Stage, we have Naomi as Andromeda from Assassin's Creed. Better beware, because we've got Chris as Sora from Kingdom Hearts! Seriously, Donald, quit wasting all my potions. Next to the stage is one hell of a butler. Dark Rose cosplay, Sebastian Ciel from Black Butler! Neko Ai cosplay as Valoria from Fire Emblem Conquest! Coming up next, we have Elizabeth as Diane from Seven Deadly Sins. The strawberry himself. Jeffrey as Ichigo from Bleach. Coming to the stage next, we have Minty Melody as Super Sonico!
From her very own animation.
You are the most famous strawberry of them all. Mew Ichigo, Queen Cosplayer from Tokyo Mew Mew! Next, we have someone who's been asleep for a really long time. Angela is a vault dweller from Fallout 4! Games for a little bit. We've got Catherine as Anders from Dragon Age 2. Yokai Beauty as Kajil from Fairy Tail. We're not anywhere near done. from a very little known anime, Bailey is Kakashi Sensei! Naruto! Attack on Titan! I was wondering when we were going to get some gemstones up in here. We've got Avery as Lapis Lazuli from Steven Universe. Them all. Stephanie has a Charizard!
Put your phones away. Put your phones away.
Next, we have Connor as Ruby Rose. You know the show. Ruby. End all, be all, queen of the gym. Maggie as a Vaporeon from Pokemon. Next up, we have Ellen as Callie from Splatoon! I think it's about time for a butt kicking hell. Caitlin as Toriel from The Hobbit! Up next, Amethyst cosplay as the first Guildmaster, Mavis Vermillion from Fairy Tail. Trying to catch this one because it's not in my Pokédex yet. Blastoise from Pokémon! Up next, We have Alpha Ned as Darth Nihilus, Star Wars. Celebration of International Sailor Moon Day, we have Wolf and Rabbit cosplay as Prince Diamond and Emerald from Sailor Moon! Cosplay is coming out as Lucille Lanella from Atelier Esha and Logie. Say it three times to get them out there, but we have the men who stare at suits as Lydia Deetz and a certain guy named Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice! Beetlejuice! Tau Chronicle as Kindred from League of Legends. Each and every one of our contestants. I'm not hearing it. Let's hear it for each and every one of our contestants. Much better, much better. The judges will be entering into some deliberation.
The judges awards. I just want to say, in addition to all the wonderful prize support that Anime Overload has put out today, and there's some great prizes, you guys. Colony Drop Cosplay donated a bunch of great prize packs for everybody that won an award this afternoon. So you guys get to dig into that. So we're going to do Judges Award. Okay, so my Judges Award, this particular contestant like put tears in my eyes in a second. I get all squishy when people like are really just living for the moment. And she came to my panel yesterday and really, really soaked in everything that I was teaching. And it was really fantastic. So my Judges Award goes to Supersonico.
I'm gonna wait a little bit of time to give her some time to get up here. Alright, so for my Judges Award, I'm gonna give it to the Blastoise. And I thought it was I'm a prop maker and I love the things. So, ever the Blastoise.
My Judges Award, I really enjoy stage presentation, just being like a cool character and keep all involved while you're on stage. Mine's going to the Fairy Tale Gender Bend of Gajeel. She scared us in the best way. Judges Award. I am also like Hee Hee and I love presentation, and we thought that this duo just looked really, really awesome. So mine is going to go to the Sailor Moon duo of Emerald and the Broom. The youth, and this one, there's a lot of great young talent out there. I am so impressed, and all of them should be really, really happy with themselves. We're gonna give best youth to Luxray. There they come. It was very hard to decide, but we picked for best novice Undyne. The craftsmanship is great, and the presentation was on point too, and everybody loved her.
So, for the best intermediate, we're gonna give it Kindred. League of Legends. Give it up.
Okay, so for Masters category, we are going to award the Best in Masters to A1 Lucille. Way! Best Masters, in addition to all their other prizes, also received $125 in cash.
Well, other than that, So I'm giving out the best craftsmanship, and I really, really love the mask. It was amazing. I know. I'm a little excited. I'm really excited. Goes to the Star Wars Darth Nihilus. Give it up for the dark side.
Okay, guys, we only have two awards left. First, we're going to do Best Presentation. Basically, this is like they practically did a skit, and everyone was enthralled from the beginning to the end. Probably know who I'm going to say. Sans and Papyrus. So the moment you have been waiting for, this is the best in show. Along with the prizes, you also get $250, so good on ya. Okay, so this one, when you're considering a best in show award, you look at craftsmanship, and then you also look at their performance on stage. And this duo, are you kidding me? It's Beetlejuice.